police reveal more details on how the assassination of Negros Oriental Governor Roel de Gamo was planned. Rafi Cabristante of ABS-CBN News Digital now joins us with that story. Rafi, what more can you tell us?
Yes, good afternoon, Carmina. The Special Investigation Task Group, or SITG, looking into the murder of Negros Oriental Governor Roel de Gamo says it is already finalizing pieces of evidence in the March 4 bloodbath. In a press conference this morning, SITG de Gamo spokesperson, Lieutenant Colonel Gerard Pilares, says they are already nearing the resolution of the killing. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla earlier made a similar pronouncement. Pilares says the SITG is now looking into forensic analysis of the getaway vehicles and firearms recovered after the killing. He says the owners of the vehicles and firearms have also been identified. An alleged mastermind in de Gamo's murder has also been identified, but Pilares did not name names or disclose additional details. Pilares also confirms that one of the assault rifles they recovered was indeed used in de Gamo's murder. Pilares also revealed additional details on the killing. He says the gunman had already been monitoring and surveilling de Gamo as early as last December. The gunmen were gathered from different places outside Negros, with some of them even hailing from Mindanao. Prior to the killing, the gunmen had already been briefed in a particular safe house and were only waiting for a right time to carry out the hit. He also describes the murder as well planned. Some of the suspected gunmen in the custody had told authorities that they had a video-recorded conversation with the supposed mastermind. Pilares also says he is confident that the remaining suspects at large have not yet left Negros Island. With this, he urges Negros Oriental residents to immediately notify authorities of the presence of any suspicious individuals in their locality. Carmina?
All right, Rafi, more on that video recording. Is there clarity now if authorities do have that video recording in their possession? And is it apparent in that video recording that the suspects had with the mastermind that they were talking to the mastermind? And you can see the face of the mastermind.
What we know so far, Carmina, is that based on the public briefing earlier this morning, PNP spokesperson, Lieutenant Colonel, Police Colonel Jean Fajardo says that the evidence or the video conversation is already probative material to build up a case into the killing of Governor Roel de Gamo. Although they have not yet disclosed details as to who the mastermind is, or they have not even confirmed if they actually have possession of the actual video conversation. But Fajardo says that they have already a testimony based on the confessions of the alleged gunmen in custody, Carmina.
Or if the mastermind was actually part of the conversation, or that the video recording only mentions the name of the mastermind, we don't know that yet.
Yes, yes, Carmina, that is correct. Mm-hmm. We have not yet identified any mastermind yet, and more details on the conversation have not yet been revealed. But DOJ Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says that they are already nearing the resolution of the case, and this is a sentiment that was already echoed by the SITG de Gamo earlier this morning, Carmina.
Hey, Raf, thanks for joining us this afternoon. Really appreciate it. No definite start yet on the distribution of a new batch of cash aid for beneficiaries of government's poverty alleviation program. See, the finance department earlier announced they will be distributing 500 pesos for 2 months to over 9 million households to help them cope with inflation. But the Social Welfare Department says they're still awaiting guidelines for the program's implementation.
In the coming days or weeks, maaari na po natin itong may-release. Admittedly, nakikita natin, maliit lang po talaga ito. Pero with this, kahit pa paano po, dahil ito'y nilikom pa po ng ating mga economic managers para po kahit pa paano madugtungan, matulungan yung ating mga kababayan dun nga sa inaharap nating taas ng presyo po ng bilihin. Sa kaya po kami naniniwala po kahit papaano ito po ay magiging malaking bagay na rin po para do sa ating mga mahihirap na kababayan.
Inflation in the Philippines eased slightly last month, but food prices, well, those remain high.